My name is Charles Fox.
And I'm Warren Miller.
And today we're going to talk about grid-tied versus off-grid solar.
Let's start off with off-grid solar. Mm-hmm. These systems are typically very rural. If you either it's too expensive for you to connect to the grid or you don't want to connect to the grid, but the real downside to them is your ability to store the expense that comes along with storing the energy that your solar produces.
Yeah, you're going to need some sort of battery pack in order for you to put the power into that you can use then at night when your solar is not producing.
Absolutely.
So if you want to run a refrigerator that needs to keep food cold, you're going to need a battery because at night, obviously, your solar system is not producing power.
Yeah. On the flip side, if you have a grid-tied system, you get to use your utility company or the grid as your storage. When you're producing electricity that you're not using, you just send it back to the grid, and then you take it back at night or when you need to use it.
That's right. And you don't need a battery then to store that power. The downside is if the power goes out, if your utility is no longer providing you power and you do not have a battery with a grid-tied system, your solar system is not going to be giving you power in your home.
It doesn't mean if you are tied to the grid that you can't have some sort of storage, whether it's batteries or a generator. You still have those options of adding those on. And so I think in an ideal world, the best solution would be a grid-tied system. And if you wanted the additional storage, you could add that on for additional costs.
That's right. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Thank you so much for watching.